Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make a track in the style of Future for his new album. And we're going to go through sound selection first. So let's go through the sounds which you can find in his only, the only song he put up on iTunes right now. It's called Fly-ish Only. You can go check it out. So right now, you know, it's kind of like an R&B vibe mixed with trap. So it's almost like trap soul, but it's not singy-songy. So let's find a guitar. So let's open up Omnisphere. Omnisphere has some good guitar samples you can start with to get that vibe. So let's open up Omnisphere. Let's go to guitars, and we're going to cycle through each until we get the guitar we want. We're going to play pluck style strumming. So we can start with this one, but it's more bluesy sounding with that vibrato. We're just looking for more of a stale pitched guitar. So let's just go through each. And we're not looking for anything super clean. So this kind of guitar would be cool. It already has all the effects we want, so it's pretty much not much to do to it. It has reverb, it has echo. And it gives you that kind of Western vibe. So let's start there. Let's right click, tap out the tempo. We're at 108 BPM. It has a nice bass to it, so you can hold the notes for bass. So we're doing octave A's, which is a common technique to do octaves when you have the bass or guitar. You do a lot of octave work, and it sounds like different notes, but it's really the same note. So let's see if we can cut out some of this bass, because the bass is super heavy in this patch. But we're going to repeat that guitar over and over again. And you can change it up every now and then. So let's go boom, dum, dum, boom, dum, dum, dum. But boom, 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 boom. And then back to boom, boom, boom. Let's see. It's a little too high pitched. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. So let's go boom, boom, boom. A lot of bass. So I'm going to edit this bass out. It's a little too much. We can open up the bass for when we have like variation sections, but right now let's just add a high pass filter to the channel one or track one to get rid of that excess bass. I'm not liking the ending because it just kind of changes the pattern. So let me figure out which note I want to hear. There we go. D is the note I want to hear. Duh. 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 Let's try this. That's what we're looking for. Okay. So that's what it was. I just couldn't hear it in my head. I just couldn't translate that tone. So that's the melody background. So this is going to be the guitar background. Don't know why we're on track three. Guitar bag. And so that's going to be our cowboy love story type of sound. So let's add that kind of R&B lead. We can do this with any synth, Silent One, any synth. Right now, we're just going to go to menu, initialize preset. It's going to be two saw voices, detuned, with mono legato and a little portamento. And we're going to add a low pass filter, or you could do this with a band pass. You're just going to go up and down your scale, creating something rhythmically that you can repeat. So I'm going to play the scale. Thank you. So let's record that lead idea. And we can repeat that over and over again. Just gonna make sure the timing is right so we don't have any weird timing issues. Slide the notes over a little bit because we have a little delay from the camera. Another thing you could do is change it to like a half step, unselect or deselect. I still don't know the proper word I'm trying to use. Hit Alt Q. I think it's deselect. I don't think unselect is a word. I need to go read the dictionary. And it's pulling you back into that like 90s rock mood. It's really gripping you. So this is the R&B lead. And we can use that over and over and over again. Only thing I don't like in the lead are the gaps. So let's close up these gaps so we don't hear those time differences. Find a kick and a snare we can add. And the drums aren't going to be super ridiculous like trappy drums. It's going to be mainly just a kick drum. So let's go to X drums. And we're going to find a kick with a lot of sub in it. And that's kick NK. It has a super amount of sub in it. And we don't necessarily need an 808 for this track. You know, don't overdo it with too much bass. So we have the kick and then we need a snare combo. So let's go to snares. Probably a snare with a clap to make it more R&B-esque. Now this snare has that vibe of that rock vibe to it, and this will fit perfect. So all I'm going to do here is add a little reverb to the snare so it has a little tail to it. Cut out some of the lows. There we go. Kick's a little too aggressive, so let's pull it back. Let's change up the pattern. And I'm gonna make every other kick pattern unique. Change it to pattern 4. And add a kick ending to the end. So it's boom, ch, boom. Rhythm there. So let's add a small hi-hat rhythm. It's going to be pretty basic. Again, it's not a trappy type of song. Let's go to pattern 5. We're going to right click fill each 2 steps, and at the very end we're going to add like a triplet kind of small hi-hat roll. So just right at the end. So much room with the hi-hat is because we're going to program in a rhythmic synth. So this is what makes the song special, is actually it's like a moving filter on the synth. So you can do this a billion different ways. It's a lot of sound design involved, so we're going to try and use plugins, but let's find some kind of moving arpeggio or something moving in Omnisphere, so we don't have to do too much sound design here. Let's go to arps, let's go to types, and let's choose the type of arp. Let's actually go to genre. Let's go to film. So it's not so tonal of an arp. And we can cycle through these right now. I'm just going to copy the chord progression or the guitar. We're going to paste that into this, but we're going to add moving filters to it. Also, this should not be on track 3. So let's hear this in context. Now the synth in the song stops. It doesn't just continue going on. So it stops at the end. It'll leave a little gap. Let's see if we can take this to the next level. I'm going to open up a plugin by SoundToys called Filter Freak 2. We're going to use. It's a moving filter. So you could set it to be threshold based, or I believe you could set it via LFO so it moves on its own. And you could set the rate here. And there's two filters. One's a bandpass, one's a low pass filter, and they're sweeping around. So if you turn up the resonance, you're going to get more of a frequency bend sound. So let's hear it. So here's the sound here. We can always move the frequencies. And it adds that extra movement that we need. And since it's on rhythm, we can set it to eighth notes or fourth notes. I liked it on fourth notes. So that's how you get that weird type of sound. Pull it up an octave so we can actually hear it. So hit Control A, Control Up. Again, the rhythm is not the same though, so you want to try different rhythms. Let's try a triplet rhythm. So let's go to triplet, 1/4 triplet. And we can always switch out the arpeggio. I'm not going to spend too much time trying to find the perfect arp, but that's the process. So let's just click on random stuff. Again, we're under the film category, so it keeps it, you know, more film-esque. It's a pretty cool one. For a cypher beat, that'd be a pretty cool sound. Here's a kind of cool one. Oh. Only thing is we need to cut out the lows, so let's add an EQ. High pass filter. Now to me, the timing's a little early, so we're gonna go to the wrench tool, turn up the time shift, so it's a little bit beyond the metronome. And that adds to the groove a bit more. Same with the hi-hat. Breakdown area, we're going to make this unique, and this is where we're going to allow the guitar to have that bass. So let's right click, create an automation clip for the EQ so that it's on during the chorusy area and off during this little breakdown section, and then back on during the rest of the verse. So here's the little breakdown section we're going to create. I'm just going to elongate all the bass notes. So let's go into pattern 2, and I'm going to, since that's the same note A, we're just going to extend that A and use all the root notes here, and it just make those longer. Now it could get messy when we get into C to the D note switch, but we'll figure it out as we go. And we can repeat that. So this is gonna have a lot of bass, and this is gonna serve as like, instead of the Moog bass that everybody uses in Drake music, this will fill up that bass gap. And might wanna get rid of the moving synth. You gotta watch the volume here though. So this is one of the things where you gotta watch. Let's go to the channel volume. Let's right click, create automation clip. Reason I'm not using the fader volume to automate it is because we may move the fader later. We don't want it to get locked into this automation clip. So I'm gonna pull up the volume. Seems like we can't even hear it anymore. Trap symbol. It's either SD or DF. I forget which one. as that loads the sample. So we're going to add that crash in. So that's on the downbeats. And then we have, you could add that every 4 bars, every 8 bars, wherever you want to add it. We can just duplicate for the verse area. For this one, I would lower the frequencies for the filters because it seems like it's too high pitched. Now that also has to do with the actual octave we use, so you got to realize it's both the effect and the MIDI. Hi-hat rolls in here to make it more of a song. And then again, the next step would be to add that vocal idea to make it a song. So let's just go back to the playlist. Let's figure out where we want to add hi-hat rolls. I'm going to say every other pattern, so let's make this unique. Select, hit Control Shift, select every other hi-hat, or you could just redo the hi-hat pattern, but let's select every other hi-hat pattern here. Let's go to the top left, go to select source pattern, change that to pattern 7, and let's add a hi-hat roll in here somewhere. Here, and I want one somewhere at the end. So let's right click, go to piano roll, and I know where we're going to have that roll. I'm going to drag out those notes. I lost the one on the left side. I should have kept that note there. So let's drag that out and drag this out so I know where the roll is. Let's delete that extra note in between. Select these by hitting Control Shift to highlight both. Go to snap to grid, half step or quarter step, and go to hit Control U. That will slice up the notes. So now let's deal with the mix. The mix is a little. We're gonna play it once with the monitors and then once without, so you don't get the extra bass. Also, I think we need a little more snare activity to fill in those gaps. So it's gonna go boom, clap, clap, just like every other southern pattern. To fill in that dead space in between. without the head, without the monitors. It's a long arrangement, so I'm going to cut it short a little bit. And the next step would be to record in the mind of the artist over the track. Enough time, I'll record a hook or a verse or something over this just to give you a vocal idea of what it sounds like with the vocal idea, and when it's mixed and slightly mastered. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want these project files, you can go to BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory, and there you can learn a lot more about music theory. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.